Hi, this is Alex from MinuteEarth. The ocean is covered with literal waves of energy, and if we could convert this energy into electricity, we could power all of humanity's electrical needs. But for now, that's just a dream. That's because we haven't yet figured out an efficient way to use waves to spin turbines. And spinning a turbine is the best way we know of to convert the mechanical energy of a moving substance into electrical energy. Aside from solar panels, pretty much all our electricity comes from spinning turbines. Wind turbines and water turbines are the most obvious, but even our coal, gas, and nuclear power plants use turbines. The fuel is just there to heat water into steam that can flow and spin a turbine. A wave, on the other hand, is not the flow of a substance as a whole. Instead, it's just the local oscillating motion of small regions of the substance. It's like how at a stadium, when the crowd does the wave moves through the crowd, but the people don't move sideways, just up and down. If the entire crowd was, say, walking around the stadium, you could imagine everyone helping twist a single big turbine on the field. But if people were just standing up and sitting down, you'd need a more complicated system to move the turbine. So, back in the ocean, most attempts at harnessing wave energy try to turn waves into something else that can spin a turbine. We've made caverns in which waves rise and fall, pressurizing air that flows past a turbine. We've made big floating pipes whose joints flex in the waves, driving pumps that pressurize fluid that can spin a turbine. And we've created what are essentially big floating bags that waves pile up into, and that water flows out of, spinning a turbine. We've also realized that at the edge of the ocean, when waves break, their water flows quickly enough to spin a turbine, but only for a few seconds at a time. So far, though, we haven't been able to get any of these turbines to spin fast enough or consistently enough to make electricity, at least cheap electricity. Building things in the ocean is expensive, and then whatever you build gets exposed to saltwater, sand, debris, barnacles, and storms, so you have to spend a lot of money repairing it. As a result, there's no commercially successful design for capturing energy from waves. We may yet be able to figure out how to make turbines commercially viable, or we may move past the turbine paradigm. We've come up with some designs that don't rely on turbines, like buoys whose bobbing movement pulls on a generator, but their electricity ends up being just as expensive as from the designs that rely on turbines. Hopefully, a new wave of wave energy will arrive someday soon, but so far, wave energy is barely making a ripple. This video was sponsored by the Okinawa Institute of Science and Technology Graduate University, an international graduate school devoted to the advancement of science, education, and innovation in Japan and throughout the world. OIST offers a fully funded PhD program and research internship opportunities that attract talented young scientists from around the world to work with researchers like Professor Tsumoru Shintake, whose wave energy project is tackling the challenges discussed in this video. So far, innovations in their turbine design have already improved power output, which is essential if wave power is ever going to become a viable energy source. To learn more about OIST, visit admissions.oist.jp.